How's it going, disc golfers? It's Mike C with What's in the Bag. First off, I've got a Nano. I've got a pair of soft Neutron Envies. These are 165 grams. These have become my putters, and I also approach with these a lot, and I drive with them sometimes too. Next, I've got this soft Proton Eclipse Node. This is a little bit understable. I like this for those real straight to slight turnover putter drives. Now I've got a soft Neutron Ion. This is pretty dead straight with just a tiny fade at the end. I like this for just real straight short shots and approaches. I want a minimal fade, but I don't want turnover. Now I've got this Max Weight Proton NV. This is more overstable than the ones that I putt with, and this fly is a little bit more overstable than the Ion and the Node do. And I like this for headwind approaches and just all around up shots when I want a dependable fade. And when the wind is really blowing, I've got this Crosslop Credo. This is my most overstable putter by far. I can trust this to hold a straight to fade line in any kind of headwind. This is a very soft, flexible plastic, and it just sticks where it lands. It's really useful for really strong headwind approaches when you just want the disc to fade and stick where it needs to be. I've got a Neutron Tangent, and this is my understable mid-range. I like this for medium range shots that just need to turn over some and hit that left to right gap. I've got a pair of the Alias. I've got one in Proton, one in Neutron, and these are just real straight with a tiny fade at the end, and they're dependable even in a mild headwind, so I've really come to like these. I've got a Neutron Tensor, and this is my overstable mid-range. I like this for long headwind approach shots and just dependable tee shots when there's a little bit of a headwind and you don't want to blow past a basket. I've got three fairway drivers. I've got a Crave, a Servo, and a Resistor. The Crave is the newest addition. I like this for straight shots or shots I want to go just a little bit left or a little bit right. It's a very neutral disc and I feel like I can shape any kind of line I need with it. The Servo is pretty similar, except it's got more fade to it, and this one will hold up a little bit better in a headwind, and I also like flicking this one. The Resistor is much more overstable than the other two, and this is my go-to headwind disc, backhand or forehand. I love the Resistor, it's one of my favorite discs. Now I carry 3 volts. This is one of the first ones I ever received from the test patch. It's a Neutron first run. It's very beat up and it has a lot of turn to it, a lot of glide. We've got this Eclipse Goldboy Volt. It's got a really cool logo on it. This one's seasoned a little bit, so it's got a little bit of turn, but it still fades back. It's pretty straight overall, but it just goes a little bit to the right. This is a fresh Neutron Volt, and this one's just dead straight with a tiny fade at the end. This is one of my favorite drivers right now. I've also got a Shock, and I throw this just like a Volt, except I use this in a headwind. And when the wind's blowing, like say 10 or 15 miles an hour, this won't fly just dead straight, just like a Volt would in calm conditions. One of the newest additions to my bag is the Inertia. I'm still learning this disc, but I like how much glide it has, and it's just a really nice combination of speed and understability that it's just allowed me to hit a couple lines out on my home course that I didn't really have the right disc for, and I'd kind of go back and forth between a few different molds. So I've been really liking the Inertia so far. Now I've got 3 Quasars. I've got a pretty beat up one that I've been using for over a year. I've got a fresh one that I haven't been throwing for that long. And then I've got this one, which is just an extra flat one that flies very overstable for me. So these three pretty much form my distance driver selection for right now. And I can just trust these anytime I need a shot to go, say 450 feet, and I can cover understable shots with this beat up one and headwinds with this one and just general straight shots with this fresh one. So there you have it, that's what's in my bag, and you can also see I'm using a Heiser Bomb Flak these days. You'll have some review videos on that coming soon, and now I'm going to go show you how these all fly.